Geelong woke to a brighter spring.
It's the only north-facing bay in Australia here, and I'm standing here looking out at the sparkling waters and people lazing back with their coffees. It's amazing. So we're grateful.
Restrictions for the city and the surf coast eased at midnight after a seven-day lockdown.
I'm surprised that Geelong got let out early. I feel sorry for Melbourne all the time. Every time this happens, I really do. But we'll take it.
The situation in Melbourne is much more bleak. This morning, students who are struggling to afford to eat formed long queues at food bank in the city. Victoria recorded 705 new cases today and another death. 363 people are in hospital, 75 of them are in ICU, and 56 of those are on ventilators. The Premier says the modelling predicted the numbers would be where they are.
It can jump around a bit, but we're on trend. We always said they'd go up. They are going up, and it's at the more positive end.
81% of the new cases are people aged under 50, and most continue to be in the northern suburbs, with Hume accounting for more than a quarter of today's infections. Pop-up school vaccination clinics are being rolled out. This one at Fawkner will operate for 3 days.
It'll be open to everybody in the community, regardless of whether they're connected with the schools or not.
So far, 33% of Victorian children aged between 12 and 15 have had at least one dose of vaccine. Our future leaders paving the way forward. Candace Wyatt for 10 News First.
And Candace Wyatt joins me on the desk tonight. Candace, GPs and pharmacies could be eligible for funding to vaccinate after hours.
That's right, Jen. So health operators across 11 local government areas are eligible for these grants, which are designed to supercharge Victoria's vaccine rollout. So GPs and pharmacies will be able to apply for them. They range between $4,000 and $10,000. Now, it's designed to help them operate for longer or perhaps rent a space next door if they want to expand, or even employ more people if they need a greater workforce to vaccinate more people faster. So at this stage, they'll be available to GPs and pharmacies in our areas of most concern. So that's Moreland, Brimbank, Cadinia, Casey, Darabin, Greater Dandenong, Hobsons Bay, Hume, Melton, Whittlesea and Wyndham. So there's an expression of interest process, Jen, and those successful pharmacies and clinics will know by October 4 if they're getting a grant or not.
Let's hope it helps. What are the vaccination rates at the moment? How are we doing?
OK, so 77.9% of Victorians have now had one dose of vaccine, while 47.7% of us have had two doses. So that's about on par with the national average, except we are lagging behind the ACT and, of course, New South Wales, which is powering ahead. So this is why those freedoms we were promised yesterday have been now delayed until Wednesday, because we didn't hit that 80% single dose vaccination target. So now, as of Wednesday, that travel limit we have will be expanded to 15 kilometres. A fully vaccinated personal trainer will be able to train 5 other fully vaccinated clients outdoors. And golf and tennis will also resume just in time for a day that's supposed to be full of torrential rain and thunderstorms, Jen.
Well, let's hope those extra hours at pharmacies and GPs can get those rates up.
Absolutely.
Okay, thank you, Candace.